Hello friends, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about for each loop container. So here we will discuss basics of for each loop container, like what for each loop does. So let's start. So for each loop container is used to loop through a set of enumerated items such as files in a directory or rows in a table. Within container, we can add one or more control flow tasks. For example, we can use execute SQL task or we can use data flow task. And we have one more container called as task host container, which is not visible from IDE, but every task is contained in it. Like we can say it is a container which contains the SSIS package. So go to on SSDT and let's have a look of for each loop container. Here I wish to add one more package. Then I need to rename this package with for each loop basic. Then inside this container, as we can see, we have for each loop container. Now we can drag and drop for each loop container and double click on this for each loop container. And here, as we can see, we have four tabs. First is general tab. Here we can specify name and description. Then collection tab, variable mapping tab, and expression tab. What we can do inside this collection tab? So in collection tab, we can select enumerator type and expressions. So as we can see, here we have enumerator and we have multiple enumerators. So we can select according to our requirement. And inside this expression, we can select the expression according to our requirement. Inside this variable mapping, we can map the variables. And inside this expression, we can use the expression according to our requirement. Next is types of enumerators. So we have total 7 types of enumerators and we will discuss one by one. So first is for each file enumerator. Second is for each item enumerator. Third is for each ADO enumerator. Next is for each ADO.NET schema row set enumerator. Next is for each variable enumerator. Next is for each node list enumerator. And last is for each SMO enumerator. So we have total 7 enumerators and we will discuss one by one in our upcoming videos. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.